Here we go.
Oh my God! Gee whiz!
Alright, on your mark, get set,
go!
Go! Oh my goodness! Woo! That was fun!
Yeah. 1, 2, hey!
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Engage.
Oh, geez.
Hey, gearheads, do us a huge favor. Hit that subscribe button down below and ring the bell so you get notified every time we post a video. And you can catch some behind the scenes stuff before it goes up here on YouTube by finding us on Facebook and Instagram, both at GT Garage Talk. And everything we do can be found at gtgaragetalk.com, including our award-winning podcast, where we interview people from throughout the automotive industry. Welcome to Garage Talk. I'm Cory. This is my wife's 2014 Jeep Cherokee, a very popular compact SUV that is our road trip rig. And this is the future of family vehicles. This is the 2021 Tesla Model Y Performance. This is a very capable, all-electric family vehicle with storage in the back, storage in the front, and yeah, it can race some sports cars and put them to shame. So, I'm gonna hop in with the help of my wife Holly and son Tucker and give you a full family review of what this is like to live with. All right, so we're gonna see just how much stuff can comfortably fit in for a family of three in the back of a traditional crossover and then the Tesla. First, full size. So, just enough clearance here in the back. Now the carry-on. Plenty of room, extra on the side, child suitcase. Pop it on top, and the bonus, kid's backpack. Not bad. Now let's check out the Tesla. All right, so at the back of the Tesla, one thing I've already noticed, even though the Tesla sits lower because of the angle of the hatch and how much hatch is actually behind the hinge point, it actually doesn't open up all the way due to our low garage door opening. Just something to note. I can bang my head on here. But as far as cargo carrying capacity, I don't think you can beat the Tesla. It easily swallows up the full size. Tons of room left over here. Carry on, no problem. And then child suitcase and the backpack. This thing has got tons of room to spare. But wait, there's more. Being a Tesla, being an electric vehicle, there is, of course, a frunk, which you can open right here from the screen. And yes, it's even big enough for my son's Lightning McQueen roller bag. All right, Gearhead, so if you watched our Expedition video, you know that I prefer putting car seats in SUVs. And this, being Tesla's volume SUV, I'm curious, just how easy is it to get a car seat in the Model Y? So first, I will note that the door doesn't open quite to 90 degrees, so it's a little tighter getting it in here. And then these white seats are, well, probably not child-friendly, but it is marked with anchor points down here at the base of the seat, and they are very easy to find. So that was not a pain whatsoever. And then to get the center rear latch in place, I've actually got to stretch it out from being in my car, fish it underneath the headrest, and come around back to the back where I can mostly easily latch it into place. All in all, not too bad. Setting off in the 2021 Tesla Model Y. It's very futuristic, right, Holly?
It is.
So, I wanted to bring you along on this because we recently had the Ford Mustang Mach-E, which is the most direct competitor to this vehicle on the market today, both in price, size, and specs. And our son, Tucker, loved that one so much that he got to come along for this review too. Can you say hi, Tucker?
Hi!
So, I have to ask you a lot of things about this because there is a lot of tech in this.
Yeah.
And I am the techie of the two of us. You are not.
Yes.
So, first and foremost, Tesla is known for their autopilot and their use of cameras to drive vehicles. And here on the screen, we actually have a readout of everything the cameras are seeing around us. It even is picking up that stop sign.
Does this one drive itself?
That is a feature that you can buy at any point in time and just pay
so
for...
So that costs more?
Pay for the software and upgrade it. So even if it did not come from the factory that way, it's just a software add-on that can be downloaded...
Of course it is!
...over the air.
Technology.
But you can see this is picking up the cones on the side of the road, fire hydrants, cars parked. It knows where the lines are in the road, even though there aren't lines in this road. It's kind of astonishing the amount of stuff that the cameras on this can pick up. That being said, this screen controls practically everything because we have a very minimalistic interior in here. Everything from the climate to exactly where the air is blowing on you, because you can't just, you know, manually move that.
Where does it come out? Right there.
Yep, so there's this giant slit across the front of the dash that blows warm or cold air on us. Press of this button right here pulls up the AC screen, and you can control with your finger exactly where the air is blowing, and then control the fan speed with that same button. So faster, slower.
Mm-hmm.
Now, riding in this, you and I have got extensive seat
and
time.
Me too.
And you too. We all have extensive seat time from our 1,200 mile road trip in the main competitor of this vehicle in the Ford Mustang Mach-E. And we commented on how well that drove and how well it rode. And I would say this is as much on par with that as possible, wouldn't you? It's very heavy, very planted. All the batteries down low are weighing it down, so it feels like a much bigger car than it is because of how heavy the batteries make it.
Yeah, what it's definitely a smooth ride.
Yep, even with the large 21-inch turbine wheels and low-profile tires, it still rides very smoothly. What are your thoughts on the interior?
This is way too mean and douche.
I'm mixed because I like the clean look of everything. But you know me in tech. I'm going to mess something up.
What do you think about...
And my main question with all tech is, what if this screen goes out and you can't drive it anymore?
Yep, because, well, it's everything.
It's everything, so, yeah.
What are your thoughts as a parent of the white interior? Because me personally, I love it. But having our three-year-old, I kind of question. I've already told him, feet out of the seat, feet out of the seat.
Yeah, but this kind of material would be easier to clean than, like, right. If it was white cloth.
Right. So this is a synthetic leather, a vegan leather, if you will. Uh-huh. That is very easy to clean. I would say any leather cleaner or maybe even a Mr. Clean Magic Eraser, who knows, would be able to make this very clean. I will comment... the lack of piano black in this, there's kind of a satin silver finish that I want.
I do like the white seats.
You like the white seats a whole lot?
I do, yeah. I don't know that it'd be my first choice with a toddler. I would feel more comfortable getting the white seats because we don't eat in a car very much. Yeah. And when we do, it's just like little snacks.
I like how it doesn't make it just a dark cave in here, having the white seats with the glass roof and the white seats. It's very bright in here and does not just feel like a coffin getting into it. So I like that about it a whole lot.
Well, it's very pretty. The outside and the inside is very pretty.
I can hear upside down.
Yeah? So cruising through town, we can see just how well the camera picks up everything around us and is showing here on the screen and communicating back to us, the driver, exactly what the car sees so that we know it knows what's going on around us, from the big trucks ahead of us to the lanes in the road. It knows that we're currently on a three-lane road. It's quite impressive how much this knows about the environment around you. And then this does have one-pedal driving, which is perfect for stop-and-go traffic. And you probably haven't even noticed it compared to the Mach-E. I know you commented on how abrupt the Mach-E's one-pedal driving felt. This is much more linear and smooth and less jerky and throw you forward kind of a feeling. And I truly appreciate the work Tesla has put into the one-pedal driving on their products. It is a very, very easy product to drive and to come to a smooth stop in traffic. One-pedal driving is a feature that I absolutely love.
But so, there's two pedals. I'm confused.
So you don't need to use the brake.
But you can.
But you can. And not using the brake, it's actually using the regeneration power. So it's actually adding power back to the batteries by not using the physical brakes and just driving with the one pedal. So as I let off of the gas, it applies that regeneration power to capture that stopping force and put it back in the battery pack.
This is the way to Mimi and Doo's.
This is the way to our Grammy and Doo's house, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, so Tucker's been begging for it. He likes to go fast. You were riding with me holding the camera the first time I drove a C8 Corvette, and I did not give you the benefit of warning you before we did an acceleration run. So consider this your formal warning. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Tucker, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Oh, oh my goodness. That is fast. What'd you do, Tucker?
What?
It was good?
Oh, it was fast.
Was that quick?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was smooth for what it was.
It made us go forward.
You want to do it one more time?
Yeah.
All right. On your mark, get set.
Go.
Go. Ah! Oh, my goodness. Woo. That was fun, huh?
Yeah.
Do you want to do it one more time?
Yes.
Okay. Can you give me a countdown?
One, two, three.
Woo! Is that fun?
Yeah.
Yeah. That is why people flock to Teslas, is the sheer thrill. Why is this car fast?
Yeah.
Well, it's got two motors, one in the front and one in the back. This has a top speed of 155 miles per
Why?
Hour.
Why?
Really fast, right?
Yeah.
And can go 0 to 60 in 3.5 seconds. That is the crazy thing about Teslas, and why people flock to buy Teslas is just the sheer joy and exhilaration and the smile. I'm smiling. You're smiling. Tucker, you smiling? With the finger in his nose. Gotta love three-year-olds. There he goes. So, this being an electric vehicle, it does need to recharge. And one of the things you and I noted on our road trip was the lack of stations out there to recharge. But Tesla is ahead of the curve on that because they own their supercharger network. It's not third party, it's all in-house. And this even comes with an adapter to plug into other chargers. So this can charge practically
anywhere. Hey, wait, look on that. Here's us.
Yep, there's us.
Right here, behind us,
this car. Yep. So this being a Tesla, being the forefront of the EV movement, there are seemingly more Tesla charges around the country than anything else. And that is true here in Tyler, Texas as well. So
Daddy, where are we?
We are going to Fresh by Brookshire's to plug into their Tesla destination charger. And what I like about this is when you shift into reverse, the rearview mirrors turn down, you've got rear camera with trajectory, and then your mirror camera is pointing at your back tires. So you can see everything around you and exactly where you're pointing this very futuristic vehicle. And there we are. Park. Let's go get some lunch.
Okay.
A few moments later.
Okay, so to turn it on, because we are just borrowing this, we don't have the phone as the key, so it'll actually tell you if you put your foot on the brake. It tells you to use this key card, place it right here, press the brake, and now it's running.
Do you need your seatbelt on?
I do need my seatbelt on. Mm-hmm. You ready to let mommy drive?
Yeah.
And then here's your drive selector. You're in drive. So this does have the strong regenerative braking turned on. So
Why
you will
you
see for yourself exactly what that one pedal driving is like. And in my opinion, it doesn't take that long to get used to. I'll see. See what you think.
Yeah. I think it just earlier it wasn't jumpy.
Yeah.
As it was just because you've gotten used to how to drive it.
Yeah. All right. So as traffic clears, we'll get a little sense of what mommy can do with the acceleration.
Oh, no.
Mommy, I want you to go fast.
He wants you to go fast, mommy.
Mommy, go fast.
Woo! Fast, Tucker?
No, that was slow.
That was slow.
That was not slow.
Three-year-old calls you out, Mom.
I just didn't go
crazy fast.
Crazy fast.
Ludicrous.
I eased into the speed.
Mommy, go fast. Not too fast.
What can I say? The boy likes to go fast. Woo-hoo!
Not that kind fast.
Not that kind of fast. So what are your thoughts as far as just general driving acceleration?
Well, it's very smooth.
Yeah.
To get up there quickly, and then it doesn't feel like you're driving as fast as you are.
It really doesn't. Like I said, it feels like a very heavy vehicle because it is a very heavy vehicle. It gives you this false sense of grandness, largeness to this otherwise compact SUV.
Hasn't taken me that long to get used to the
one pedal. Yeah, like I said, it becomes fairly natural right off the bat.
It just takes you a minute.
All right, so here we are on one of the smoothest, newest roads in Tyler. and this thing's comfortable. It's quiet. It's smooth. How's the driving experience?
It's nice.
Nice.
Smooth.
So, as the new age of cars, it's very simple. What are your thoughts of getting used to not having a screen directly in front of you and having to peer over here to the side?
I already have a screen over here in my Jeep, so I'm used to looking at both kind of anyway. But for the speed limit, it's a little different, but...
Yeah. One of those things, kind of like the one-pedal driving, you pick up rather quickly?
Yeah.
So, Tucker, what do you think of... Mommy surprised me! Was that fast enough, Tucker?
Yeah. I will do it in 1, 2, hey!
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Yeah, Mommy!
Woo! That was fun. I like it. You like it? You've got a smile.
I like it. I'm not a rule breaker, though.
It made it hard to go backwards.
Yeah?
Yeah. So...
Was that fast?
If we were merging onto the interstate...
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Or had to zip around a car in traffic. Plenty of power, instantaneous, right?
Instantaneously. Smooth. Very smooth.
And that's the real life...
get into trouble.
Exactly. That's the real life application of this, though, is in a situation where you need to quickly get around somebody, the power is there without having to find the right gear to find the perfect amount of power. It's just there when you tell it to be there. And
it seems like that's a safer driving.
Yeah. Safer. There's no hesitation. There's no stall. You just go. Could you see this as a daily driver?
Yeah.
Day.
Yeah. Day. Like, well, day. With the... Day.
Hold on. Day. Yes, sir? So, could you see yourself driving something like this on the daily?
Yeah. 100%.
100%?
100%. It's smooth. It's comfortable. You know, you can fit a car seat in the back. But yeah, I like the car. It's fun. It's pretty.
Yeah. So Teslas are notoriously ridiculed for their build quality. As just your everyday car driver and enthusiast, what are your thoughts on the build quality from our short time here in the Model Y?
I like it.
Yeah.
I think it's nice. I don't see anything.
It does not feel incredibly cheap. You know, everything you hear on the internet is build quality. It's terrible. Creaks, rattles, misalignments. So far, we're yet to find anything that is just a major detriment to us. And I've kind of looked for panel gap issues. And then again, the interior in here is quite well put together. It's minimal.
Mm-hmm. I think it's nice and clean and smooth looking. I like that, not feeling like cluttered.
I just wish this didn't look so bolted on.
Yeah.
I like the Model S and Model X, the bigger siblings of this. It's more of a built-in screen than a tacked-on screen. But other than that, yeah, it's clean, it's simple. I do wish you didn't have to go through the screen to adjust the airflow, but, I mean...
I like that, though.
You do?
Yeah, the non-tech person, I like that.
Shocker!
Yeah, because I feel like it gives you more versatility of where your air is going versus just like up and down, left and right. Because I was able to adjust the airflow the best way I thought it would reach Tucker faster.
Hot take right there.
There
the non-techie likes the very techie air conditioning adjustments in the Tesla Model Y. All in all, I'm nowhere near as down on the interior build quality as I thought it would be.
Daddy, I want Bob.
You want your spot? Where is he, Tucker?
He's napping.
There he is. I see him. You want spot?
Uh-huh.
There you go, buddy. Uh-oh. There you go, buddy. All right, gearheads. So as fun as the giggle pedal is in this, and those crazy acceleration speeds, I do want to test out some of the autonomous features of this, because that is also something Tesla is known for. And it is showing me here on the screen all the traffic around me. It sees the stoplights that I can't even see because of the expedition in front of me. And it's gonna navigate us through traffic. And hopefully when we get towards more open highway, autopilot will actually engage. So we'll see how this goes. Cue the time lapse. So, full autopilot, very intuitive. I like it. Does exactly what it says it's going to do, and helps you out by putting on the screen exactly where you are in the lane, showing you that it knows what's around you. All right, gearheads, that about does it for this Tesla Model Y. Huge thanks to Mercedes-Benz of Tyler for loaning us this 2021 beautiful example with 4,000 miles on it. If you want to see more of what's in their inventory and learn more about maybe even this exact Tesla, we will link down in the description below their website so you can see everything on their lot. If you wouldn't mind, hit that subscribe button down below and ring the bell so you get notified every time we post. And if you want to find some behind the scenes stuff from us, maybe learn a little bit about what we're driving before it's here on YouTube. Go find us on Facebook and Instagram, both at GT Garage Talk. And everything we do can be found at gtgaragetalk.com, including our podcast where we interview people from throughout the automotive industry. Until next time, bye.
Oh my goodness, it's so fast. Oh.
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Brace for impact.
Okay. Oh. Oh my lord.
Tucker, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Let's go.
Oh my goodness.
Here we go.
Go. Oh. Go.
Oh, yeah? You're so silly.